said it was. How'd you think practice?
Oh, it was cool. It was cool. You know, at first I didn't want to get into this little league thing.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, I thought it was kind of strange. Don't want to hang around little boys swinging bats and balls all day, you know.
Well, man, change is.
Hold up. Now, I didn't say nothing about being scared.
Man, you know what? All I'm saying is I'm proud of you, kid. It's not easy telling your life around. But you know what my philosophy is? It ain't worth having.
True that. That being said, what's up with you and wifey?
You know, it's about straight around me, man. I'm so scared of my kids since you left. Because of my past,
hey, that's a bunch of bull.
Yeah, man. I won't be able to see my kids, and that's why they had to switch teams, man. I won't be able to see them until after the court date. And even then, I bet this will have to be supervised.
Man, that's messed up. Crazy, man. Should we almost like, what, at the end of the season now?
Yeah, man, I haven't seen my boy since April, beginning of the season. Mm-hmm. But you know what, man? I'm taking care of his other kids, man. And I'm praying that God is blessing my boy, and the role model is taking care of him too, you know?
I hear you. So, what's up with you then?
What's up with me? Man, I'm just trying to maintain.
I understand that, but you're a man though, and you got needs.
You know?
Yo, and I see how you be working with a little big dude on the team and checking out his moms.
Ah, man, what are you talking about? CJ?
Yes, CJ. What's up with that?
Well, she's a nice lady. She used to go to the church a year ago. Her husband died.
That's sad and all, but the way I see it, you single, she single.
Come on.
Nah. I'm serious, Rev, man. You should ask out. Come on, Rev. What you got to lose? Aren't you the one who's always telling me that sometimes God has to break you all the way down so that he can build you back up?
Ready to order? Wait so long. I stopped by Annette's to check on her and invite her to have lunch with us after I left church.
I've been meaning to ask how she was doing.
Well, I don't know. She wasn't home.
I talked to her last night to see if she was going to come for prayer breakfast with us this morning. But she said she wasn't up to it. Said she's not ready to come back to church yet.
I honestly feel her on that.
Thank you.
So how'd you think the show went?
Oh my God, it was awesome.
It was.
I'm so glad that we settled in the lobby, so I can be about to take the time to see what it did to
the house. That's what's up. I'm glad you like it.
Me too. I mean, there's really nothing to think about.
Really? Like what?
I don't know. Ever since Cedric and Monty died, I've been mad at God. And tonight in that theater, I felt like it was his him and me. And he was all up in my business checking. Oh, I'm still mad.
God is sovereign. He does what he wants, when he wants, how he wants. He's not like us. He doesn't make mistakes. You know, when Asia gave you that decision that day in the sanctuary, of all places, I truly considered turning my back on God to hold on to my marriage. But when I went to chase after her and saw the Kevin dude got shot, I knew right then and there that I had to trust him to stay committed to my family.
Wow. I didn't know it would sound like that.
Most people don't.
So you were willing to risk everything in order to follow your call.
Paul says, to live is Christ, and to die is gain.
Wow.
I had no other choice.
You have any regrets?
We all have regrets in life, but you know, I choose to stay focused on the work that God has to do for me. Besides, if I wouldn't have done what I'd done nearly a year ago, Kevin would probably still be on the streets, possibly locked up or maybe even dead right now.
That's very possible.